Hello everyone, welcome back to another exciting video on React Native Expo. I am Rohit Kumar Thakur and today I will be showing you how to read PDF files in React Native and Expo apps. But before we dive in, I want to clarify a few things. Please note that this project won't work on the Expo Go app as I will be using the React Native PDF package, which is a native module and cannot be used directly with the Expo managed workflow. To use this package, you will need to either eject your Expo project, use the bare workflow, or use the development build to test your application. Don't worry, I will make the source code of this project publicly available, so you will have access to it. However, I highly recommend that you follow the video carefully to ensure you successfully complete the project. Let's get started. Launch the Expo application and choose the blank template. Give your application a name and proceed to download the required dependencies. Feel free to follow and DM me on Instagram or Twitter for any query or to join our developers community. Before we proceed, make sure to install the required packages, watch the video and install them one by one. And don't forget to add these two plugins inside the app.json file. As you may know, I prefer to write project code in a separate directory, so create a source folder and an index.js file inside it. Next, import the JavaScript component into the main app.js file. First, import the PDF component from the React Native package, then create a constant called PDF resource, which will hold the URI of our PDF file. Don't forget to set the cache to true. Now inside the view component, we need to write the code to render the PDF file using the PDF component. Let's add some basic styling to enhance the appearance. Great, we are almost there. However, remember that I mentioned earlier that this project won't work on the Expo Go app. Therefore, we will proceed with the development build. To do this, follow the steps outlined in the official documentation. First, we need to install the EAS CLI. Next, install the Expo Dev Client. Now, as per the documentation, we have to log into our Expo account. If you don't have one, create an account before proceeding. Once you are logged in, copy and paste the following command into your terminal to start creating a build for the device. Some questions will be asked during the process, so keep the default setting by hitting enter and select yes when prompted. You can also follow along with the video for further guidance. After the build is complete, scan the provided QR code and download the build. Install it on your device. Run the command npx expo start dev client in your terminal. You should see the output on your screen. Now scan the URL and manually copy and paste it into the newly installed build. Wait for the build to finish and you will see that our application is working perfectly, smoothly rendering the PDF. This is my book, which I wrote specifically for developers. You can find the link to this book in the description below. If you are new to development builds, let me clarify that you can make real-time changes to your project. It's not a static state. Let me demonstrate by adding a title to this application. Great, you can see the changes and the title being updated in real time. That's all for this video. Please share your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and I will see you in the next React Native and Expo video.